What's going on, everybody? My name is David Paxit with Beloved Custom Designs, also known as BKD. All right, I want to show you a little trick that I learned here. What I'm doing is I want to make realistic hair. I want to show you how you can make realistic hair creating your own tool, your utensil. And what I got here is a brush, all right, a regular old painting brush, a little bit of tape, and all I did was I cut off a few pieces of the bristles off the paintbrush. All right, I taped it with a regular masking tape. I like electric tape. I can't find it, but electric tape sticks a little bit better, and it doesn't pull as much, because what I'm going to be doing is laying it across. All right, in here I'm going to spread it out, and I'm going to start airbrushing over it. And what's going to happen is I'm going to color the negative space that's not there, which is going to create dark shadows. I don't know if you can see that in here, but what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to layer down my hair. All right, what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you. So what I did was I'm laying it down here. I spread it out the way I want my hair to kind of look. All right, and I'm just going to lightly mist around it, okay? And what it's going to do is it's going to start creating sharp whiskers, all right? So it's going to look more realistic. And you spread them around. Now, the problem is that as you start to paint, I don't know if you can see it, as you start to paint it, all right, you're starting to see it get, I'm coloring my bristles. And they're sticking together, so you have to kind of like feather them out. But that's also cool, because as you start to feather them out, all right, they spread and they're giving the whiskers more of a unique look, all right. And I'm just gonna start moving them around. However, all right, moving them throughout the mural, all right, because I'm also going back over with my white in the areas that I want to be more dominant, because of course the tiger is more, it's white, it's black and white stripes. So I did a little bit down here, alright, because what you're going to do, it's going to look like the underneath hair on the painting, alright, and then he looks a little bit dirty, but it's giving it a great dimension and look. Hopefully I'm not in your way. As I'm showing you this, if I am, I'm sorry. Okay. As you can see that, I'm going to go and fill up my white, Create Text White. I'm going to fill it up just a tad. All right. I'm going to go back in there for the sake of it. All right, I'm going to spread out our brush. I'm going to go back in there. There you go, look at that. Creating more lifelike whiskers. You can kind of drag it down, open it up a little bit some. Go back in there. Okay. Move with some jagged strokes. Okay, as you see that, looks more realistic than it did before. It looks more realistic than it did before. I'm really excited the way it's looking. Maybe even touch it up in here. You know? Just to give it a little bit of dimension. Go back over here. Look at that, it's looking nice. Right, let's go back up here, because it's looking a little bit more textured with the fur. All right, in and kind of feather it back in and blend it in so it looks more realistic than it did before. Well, there you go. That's a little quick tutorial tip on how to create your own stencil using a paintbrush, tape, and a little bit of creativity. All right.